In this video, we'll be looking at calculating the area and the perimeter of two-dimensional shapes, including compound shapes, which are where a shape is constructed by more than one recognizable polygon. We'll also be looking at using the correct units of measurement for both area and perimeter. Before watching this video, can I recommend that you watch the video on polygons and measurements and conversions, as that's referenced several times during this video. The first shape we'll look at is a rectangle. And here we're asked to find the formula for the perimeter of a rectangle. The perimeter always refers to the length of the line that runs around the outside of a shape. Here, we could add all the sides together to calculate the perimeter, but we can also write it as an equation, such as 2 times the length plus 2 times the width. Or we could simplify it even further by factorizing it into 2 times length plus width. All these are different versions of perimeter, but in essence, it's the same with any shape. You simply measure the length around the outside. It's important to remember here that we are just adding lengths together, so the unit of measurement will remain one-dimensional, meaning the power will be 1, or just not noted. In the next example, we have a rectangle measuring 7 centimeters by 12 centimeters. So we can calculate the perimeter using our formula as before. P equals 2 times 7 plus 12. That's P equals 2 times 19, which would give us 38 centimeters. In calculating that perimeter, we use the measurement of centimeters because it's a length and therefore single dimension. So the power is going to be 1, which we don't write. In this next problem, we've got an isosceles triangle. So knowing the properties of an isosceles triangle, I know I can assume two of these lengths are equal, as signified by this notation lines. We can safely state that this side is also 12 meters, and the base we can see is 5 meters. In the same method as for a rectangle, we just have to measure all the lengths and add them together, so we can say 12 plus 12 plus 5 equals 29 meters. Again, we're using the units of measurements that have been used in the problem. In the next polygon, we've got a regular hexagon. They've only given us the measurement for one of the sides of this hexagon, but because it's a regular polygon, we know that all the sides are the same length, so we can assume that all these sides are 6 centimeters. As we're told it's a hexagon, we know there's going to be 6 sides, so we can do 6 times 6, which will give this perimeter of 36 centimeters. Here, we're looking at how to calculate the area of shapes, the first one being a rectangle. Here we're asked to find the formula for the area of a rectangle, and this basic polygon shows us the concept of finding all the areas of shapes. The area is defined by the space taken up by a two-dimensional shape, which is to find out how many square units of measurement fit inside the shape. So if we say this rectangle measures 4 centimeters by 2 centimeters, we can split it into centimeters squared like this. We could simply count the number of squares, which would be 8. But a shortcut to finding the area of a rectangle that uses larger numbers for its dimensions could be calculated by multiplying its length times its width. And this is our formula. Area equals length times width. As an area considers two dimensions, we use the power of 2, or squared, over the unit of measurement. The reason that we focused on rectangles at the start is that when we look at compound shapes, we try and cut them into shapes that are simple to calculate, and a rectangle is a very common one to use. So here we've got a compound shape, and we're asked to find the area and the perimeter. First, we should notice that we have to calculate the missing dimensions up in that top right-hand corner. As we're told that all of these are right angles, we can calculate that as 8 take away 6 would be 2 meters for this one, and this one would be 4 take away 3.5 to give us half a meter, or 0.5. We can only do this because they are right angles. Now, let's look at calculating the area first. Because this is a compound area, we want to cut it into shapes that we can easily calculate. So I'm going to draw a line down here, which leaves us with a large rectangle and a smaller one. We can calculate the large rectangle to be 6 times 4, 24 meters squared. In order to work out the area of the smaller rectangle, we can do 2 times 3.5, which gives us 7 meters squared. As a compound shape is the sum of two or more shapes, we can just add these two areas together to get 31 meters squared. In order to calculate the perimeter, we simply add up all the sides together. 4 plus 6 plus 0.5 plus 2 plus 3.5 plus 8. If we notice that several of these areas sum to 10, we can get 10 plus 4 plus 10, which would give us 24 meters. So that's the perimeter for this shape. Here we have a triangle. In order to calculate what the area is, we need to know two things. Firstly, the base, secondly, the height. In order to find the height of a triangle, you need the perpendicular line from the base to the furthest point from the base. Here we're symbolizing it with a dotted line. But if it was a right angle triangle, you'd see the two perpendicular lines and you can measure it from there. Now, to understand the formula for the area of a triangle, we need to create a rectangle from this base and this height. We'd end up with four triangles, two in the middle and these two on the outside. As the area of these triangles are all the same, and there's four of them, of which we only need two, we can say that the area would be the base times the height divided by two. As you can see, it's the same as half the rectangle that would be formed by the base and the height. In this case, if the base was 10 centimeters and the height was 18, we'd do 10 times 18, all divided by 2, which is 180 divided by 2, which equals 90 centimeters squared. Here we have a trapezium to work out. We need to know three parts to calculate the area of this shape. Side A, which is the top, side B, which is the base, and the height of the trapezium. As the top and the bottom of this shape are parallel, we can add them together and divide the result by 2 to get a mean average of this measurement. Now we can multiply that by the height because this is the perpendicular line that runs between these two parallel lines. We tend to designate the two parallel lines as A and B for the sake of this formula. So we get A plus B all divided by 2 and then times by the height equals the area of a trapezium. So if we say that A was 4 feet and B was 7 feet and the height equaled 10 feet, we could calculate it as 7 plus 4, all divided by 2, and then times by 10. This would give us an area of 55 feet squared, or 55 square feet. Again, the unit of measurement is squared because we're looking at a space inside the shape, and therefore two dimensions. Let's have a look at finding the area of a parallelogram. This is quite simple because it's very similar to a rectangle. If we were to cut the corner off here and move it to the other side, which we can do because the top and bottom are parallel and the sides are parallel, we'd create a rectangle. We can continue to calculate the area as base times height in the same way as we would do a rectangle, which is length times width. So we can write the formula, area equals base times height. Here we've got a pentagon because it's got five sides. It has a corner cut off here. Instead of cutting the shape into two shapes, I'm going to calculate what the triangle would be if I added it on to create the rectangle. And then I'm going to subtract that from the area of what the rectangle would be. Firstly, we should notice that the answer is going to be given in centimeters. It's easier to convert lengths than areas, so let's do that now by dividing each of these millimeters by 10, because there's 10 millimeters in a centimeter. So that's 5 centimeters, 4, 7, and 2 centimeters. If we recreated the triangle in this corner, it would be 2 centimeters, 7 take away 5, and 2 centimeters, 4 take away 2. The area of this missing triangle, base times height divided by 2, is going to be 2 times 2 divided by 2, so it's going to equal 2 centimeters squared. The area of the rectangle would be, if you included that triangle, 7 times 4, 28 centimeters squared. So 28 centimeters squared for the whole rectangle, subtracting the 2 centimeters would give us an area of 26 centimeters squared. And that's the answer for what the area of this shape is. Sometimes it's easier to subtract a missing part than it is to divide a part into more complex areas. And this was a good example of that. In this problem, we've got a pentagon, but we can cut it into a triangle and a trapezium. Let's label each of these to show how we are calculating the answer. Section A will be the trapezium and section B will be the triangle. For section A, we need to do 8 plus 6 divided by 2, which equals 7. And then we times that by the height of 10 centimeters to get 70 centimeters squared. If the base of the triangle is 8 centimeters, we need to calculate the height. So we're going to do 14 take away 10 to give 4 centimetres. Then we'll do 8 times 4 divided by 2, which would give us 16 centimetres squared. If we added those two together, we'd get 86 centimetres squared. In this question, we're given a compound shape with measurements given to us in terms containing variables. And we're asked to give the area as an expression in its simplest form. Again, as we have done with the other compound shapes, I'm going to cut it into shapes that I can easily calculate. So I'm going to cut this down here to create two rectangles and calculate each area independently. The one to the left is 2a times 4b, which equals 8ab. We need to calculate the length of this top side, which is 7a take away 2a, which will give us a length of 5a. We can then do 5a times 2b to get 10ab. We can't evaluate it because we don't know what a and b represent, but we've shown it in its simplest form to calculate it once we know what those variables do stand for. In this video, we looked at how to calculate the perimeter and area of two-dimensional shapes for a whole range of polygons and compound shapes. We also looked at the units of measurement that we'd use for perimeter and area, which is very much dependent on what the original dimensions are measured in. In the next video, we're going to look at volume, which is a calculation of the space contained within a three-dimensional shape. I'll see you then.